if you go into essence of sunscreen, it is a coating which was developed by some material scientist. And yes, we are creating sunscreens for satellites which not only protect them just from UV, but also from a lot of other stuff such as atomic oxygen and fast-moving ions.
To put a material into space like carbon fiber, we need to make sure that these materials last there. So we're looking into developing coatings that are integrated into the fabrication process.
The material scientists have that unique ability to be able to reinvent how we build things and grow things, and for the space environment, for a very unique environment.
Carbon fiber or additive manufacturing using carbon fiber for space is a very new technology. There has not been a lot of testing out there.
We're sending up more and more stuff into space. We send up more and more satellites, which is an environmental issue, but also a cost issue.
So now, if we can make a satellite structure or a rocket body, which has the same strength, same structural and mechanical strength, but maybe half the weight of what it is currently, we can save a lot of money, we can save on a lot of fuel, and it will help accelerate this race to space.
New space allows us to think outside the box. It allows us to bring new ideas, new technologies to a regime that we've done very conventionally up until now.
It'll be a game changer in how much we can actually send up. We can make things smaller and smaller and lighter and lighter.
On Earth, the environment is completely different as compared to that of space. That is why we need to make these coatings which will either protect it from atomic oxygen, UV, or those high energetic ions.
The requirements in space are a bit different from what we have here on Earth. So they need to be structurally very stable, but they're also in a vacuum. So they need to be very dense and uniform, so they can't have too many voids in between the structures. So you have to be very careful with how you place and fabricate the parts, so you don't have that, so they don't delaminate.
At the heavy ion accelerator facility, we are recreating the space environment on Earth. And then to ensure that our coatings can withstand the test of time, we are irradiating them up to 10 times more radiation that a satellite would endure in its normal life.
It's a harsh environment up there, and we need to make sure that these parts last.
We are still in process of improving our coatings and learning every day how our coatings are behaving to these conditions, and we are further improving them.
So the project we're working on is together with a company called New Frontier Technologies. They are developing bespoke carbon fiber composite parts for rocket body structures and satellite structures.
When we are developing these coatings, we are going to make prototype parts. And the first prototype that we are going to make is a strut that is going to be part of a satellite.
Once this coating is developed, we can use it for all kinds of parts in space because it's directly integrated into the fabrication process. So we don't need to test all the different parts. We just need to develop the coating once, and then you can integrate it in the fabrication of any part that you send in space.
In 5 years' time, we might be looking at how do we do re-entry? How do we do microgravity research, pharmaceutical production in space? And we want to be able to get that those vehicles and those components back down to Earth. But without protection from coatings, it might be very difficult to do so.
It is a very exciting challenge for me, especially as a material scientist.
It would be very cool to, you know, have a first part that uses these materials and coatings sent into space.
And seeing them go from that to translation and hopefully to products on our supply chain, putting Australia out there, I think that's just fantastic.
And yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing the coatings that we develop here at Australian National University one day be up in space.